This lecture just a continuation of previous lecture, that is identification of wasp, bees, ant or hymenopteron insect part 2, right? We have seen about character, order character in last class. This class start with the families of both suborder Symphyta and Apocryta, right? Let's start from Symphyta. Family is 10th Rhynidae, common insect is sawfly, right? Here they are a wasp-like insect, right? Abdomen is broadly jointed to thorax. Their oviposition is sawtoothed and suitable for slicing the plant tissues. Here, important is their larvae is erysiform, that means polypod, right? It resembles like a lepidopteran caterpillars, right? It has one pair of ocelli also, right? And three pairs of thoracic legs and having 6 to 8 pairs of abdominal legs. Listen, here normally Lepidopteran caterpillar having mostly 5 pairs of, maximum 5 pairs of prolegs in abdomen. But in the case of sawfly caterpillar having 6 to 8 pairs of abdominal leg, pseudo legs or false leg, right? Here prolegs lack crochets, right? But crochets only present in or highly developed in case of Lepidopteran caterpillar, right? Okay, they are external feeders on foliage, right? Is only one, the pest in the case of Hymenopteran order, right? Larvae while feeding usually has the posterior part of body coiled over the edge of leaf, right? That will damage, right? Example is mustard sawfly or cucurbit sawfly. Athalia lugens proxima feeds on mustard and cruciferous vegetables like broccoli or cauliflower, etc. Right? In Symphyta, having only one family insect, that is sawfly, right? Here we have seen the it having serrate or saw-shaped oviposition. That's why it is called sawfly, right? See the saw-like serration on its oviposition. See the saw-like serration on its ovipositor. Right? It's a peculiar character of this sawfly, 10th Rhynidae family, and this insect will be mostly black and yellow, right? Normal fly, and the abdomen is broadly attached to thorax, right? These are the very important character to our 10th Rhynidae family, right? Colors and oviposition shape and abdomen joint, right? Okay. Next, suborder Apocryta. This suborder Apocryta having all other wasp, bees, etc., right? Here major one is honeybees, our honeybees, Apidae family honeybees. We can get a natural honey from this order, this order families. Okay, their body is covered with the branching and the plumose hairs, a peculiar character of honeybees, fully covered by plumose hairs, and mouth parts are achieving under lapping type. Mandibles are suited for crushing and shaping bags, building combs, not for biting and not for biting, right? Here mandibles not suited for biting, but used to crush the wax or crush the pollen and nectar content and shaping the wax. So wax is the inner content of nest, honeybee nest, right? Honeybee nest constructed full by wax content, right? Okay, and legs are specially modified for pollen collection. Pollen and nectar collection, and pollen highly collected by legs, right? Nectar collected by mouth parts. And here pollen basket is present in hind tibia, right? They are social insect with three caste, right? Queen, drone and worker. Temporal separation of duties is noticed among the worker. That means each and every instar or period of weeks they have different type of works, right? Like foraging, like building vaccine, like feeding for young ones, like that, the duties of workers will vary based on this instars. And best example is Indian honeybee, Apis india. It's a productive insect category, right? Okay, and you have a structural modification in legs, wings and body parts will be seen in 3D lecture. And next, Apidae family insect honeybee, right? Here important character of honeybee, right? Just see the honeybee. Here first character is hairs on the body. Here body having plumose type of hairs all over the body. Mostly there is plumose type of hairs present all over the body, right? To pick the pollen and nectar content from flowers, this will help the pick the pollen from flowers, right? Plumose type of hairs present in honeybees. Okay, next character having pair of compound eyes, right? And three number of ocelli. Right, three number of ocelli and antenna. Antenna is geniculate type of antenna, right? Having 11 flagellomere, right? Having 11 flagellomere, right? Each antenna having 11 flagellomere and having lapping and chewing type of mouthparts. Chewing type of mouthparts. Chewing and the lapping. Here mandibles, see the mandible. Here mandibles highly modified for to blend the pollen pollen powders from flowers, right? It just blend and crush the pollen powders from flowers. And this lapping tongue, right, it's a help to lick the nectar content from flowers, right? Lick the nectar content from flowers. What do you mean by nectar and pollen? I have already told about nectar and pollen. Nectar means powder substance or powdery substance of flowers, right? And nectar means liquid substance of flower, right? Here the liquid substance will lick by or smeared by the mouth parts, that is lapping and chewing type of mouth parts, right? By this lapping unit, it will lick the nectar content or liquid content from flowers. Okay, sir. And all other parts, right, like this hair, right, like this hair or legs and wings, antenna, all like etc. These are will collect the pollen, right, powdery substance of flower, right. So, either powder substance collect panum, either nectar content collect panum. Right, so basic question. And next one is legs, right? Coming to legs, legs pathing abdina appendages of thorax, right? Thorax having locomotion appendages, that is wings and legs. If you take foreleg, right, foreleg of honeybee, right, there is an important structure called antennal cleaner. Right, here this structure will clean the antenna for pollen, right, or collect the pollen from antenna region, right? See this picture, tibial and femur modification present in four leg, right? Each four leg having modification, that is called antennal cleaner. That means this structure will clean the pollen content from antenna, right? Not only antenna and mouth parts or head region, right? The forehead associated with the head, right? Okay, what about mid leg modification, right? There is important structure in mid leg, that is see the 3D view. There is a spur-like structure, right? Spine-like structure present in mid tibia, right? Each mid tibia having spine-like structure, right? This spine-like structure will use to clean the spiracles, right? Clean the spiracle in both thorax and abdomen, or you can say gaps, right? To clean the gaps present in abdomen and thorax, right? See the gaps. This is the spiracle, right? These are the spiracle present in lateral side of thorax and abdomen. This will clean the spiracles, not only the spiracles, also clean the gaps present in abdomen and number thorax. Look, sir, what about hind leg? Right, see the hind leg. Hind leg, there is a structural modification called pollen basket. Right, here pollens are loaded, collected pollens are loaded. Right, it will be loaded from mid leg and foreleg. Right, and other modification of wings. Right, wings. What about wings? Wings are membranous, right? And there is a special structure, right? Structure present in hind wing, that is spines. See the spines. This is hind wing. There is a spines present in anterior portion of wings, right? Each hind wing having n number of hook-like structure on it hind wing. Right, this hook-like structure that is called hamelin. Right, these are the hamelin. This hamelin structure will interconnect with the forewing. Right, this is a hind wing. This is a forewing. Right, here hind wing having this hamelin structure in anterior region. This will interconnect with the forewing, and it will fly. This hamelin like structure present in both wings, both hind wings. Okay, and coming to abdomen posterior region, there is a string like appearance or spine like appearance present end of the abdomen, right? It's called sting, honeybee sting. These are the important character. Here, sting is associated with poisonous gland of honeybee. Right? This sting will connect to poisonous gland of honeybees. Right? After each sting of honeybee, it will automatically detach from abdomen, its abdomen, and the honeybee will die automatically. Right? Okay. These are the character of family Apidae honeybees.
Okay. And next family is Spiceidae, thread waisted wasp or digger wasp or mud dauber. Right, here see the picture. Here lateral extension of the pronotum form a lobe like structure, right, which is absent in the hornet or next family, right? So difference between hornet and wasp, thread waisted wasp, right? You can see distinct petiole like structure between thorax and abdomen, and eggs are laid in paralyzed or killing host, right? That means it will kill the host, right, by inserting its egg, right? Okay. Next is Vespidae, yellow jacket and hornet. Here lateral expansion of pronotum each point of insertion wings and do not form a round like lobe like structure, but lobe like structure will present in threaded wasp, right? This is a difference between yellow jackets and the previous thread waisted wasp. Okay here abdomen is conical. See the picture. Abdomen is conical. Here they construct the nest with wasp paper like substance made from fragment of chewed wood mixed with the saliva. Right, chewed wood mixed with the saliva. They are either solitary social web. Here what we mean by solitary, right? Here solitary means single insect can cause a high damage, right? High damage on our pest, right? These are effective predators, okay? As per effective predators, and they are generally predaceous on Lepidopteran caterpillar, okay? It will prefer the larvae, Lepidopteran larvae, that will actually pest on crop plant, right? And it will lay its eggs on that caterpillar, and eggs will develop inside that caterpillar and destroy or kill the caterpillar or kill the pest. And that's why it is called solitary predators, right? Example is yellow banded wasp. It's important of bee enemy, right? It will catch and kill the bees, adult bees, right? Next one is thread-waisted wasp. Right. There is a elongated petiole-like structure between thorax and abdomen, right? It's a special character of thread-waisted wasp. Okay, and there is a lobe-like structure, right, present in lateral side of lobe-like structure present in thorax, right? These are the special structure of thread-waisted wasp. Okay, and coming to hornet, right? Hornet wasp. Here, abdomen is conical shaped abdomen, and there is no lobe-like structure present in thorax, right? Which is present in thread-waisted wasp, right? These are the structural modification of Spicidae family and the Vespidae family, right? Robust bees. Dorsum of abdomen is bare and pollen basket is are absent in hind leg, right? Which will present in normal honeybees, right? But brushes of hair are present on hind wing. Hairs will present. They build the nest in dead log or broken plant pots and live in branches. They tunnel in all directions and do not feed on woods. The tunnel is portioned into several cells separated by cemented wood chips. After feeding this pollen nectar on each cell, the larvae hatch and feed and grow and pupate inside the each and every cells. Adult are not aggressive and do not sting. So don't worry to mow in sesame of green manure crops, right? It's mostly present on green manure crops. Next family is bumblebee. Bumblebee, Psilocopidae. Well, bumblebee having plumose type of hairs all over the body, and it's a bee but without leg modification, right? We have seen the leg modification of honeybee. But in the case of bumblebee, there is no structural modification in legs. And this is not aggressive, so we need not to worry about this sting, about its sting. Okay, next is Formicidae, our ant. Here, they are common widespread insect, antennaized geniculate. Mandible is well developed, wings present only in sexually matured form. Petiole may have one or two spines, okay. And they are social insect having three caste system, queen, male and worker. Here workers are sterile females and they form the bulk of the colony. Exchange of food material between adult and immature insect is common, right? Prophylaxis. After mating, flight queen alone find the suitable nesting site. Here wings break near the abscission suture, near the base of nipped off by mandibles. Eggs laying is started after shedding of wings. Usually the queen does not forage the food. If you take ant, there is a few important characters, right? So geniculate type of antenna normally having genicular type of antrum in all over hymenopteran insect, and ant having well developed mandibles, strong mandible, right, well developed strong mandibles, pair of mandibles, and having long slender legs. And there is a petiole like structure, right, there is a peculiar segment present between number thorax and abdomen, right, it's a special character of ant. There will be a chance to present a spine like structure between thorax and abdomen, or there is a spine like structure present in petiole, right, it's an important character of ant. Formicidae, family, order, Hymenoptera. Not only one spine, there will be chance to present two or more than one spine, right? Okay, bro. See the spine like structure. Okay, bro. And some cases there will be spine present on this segment also, right? Propodium. Okay. These are the special structure in 3D view. Okay, pa. Let's continue with the other families. Talcidae. They are small to medium sized insect, and hindcocks are 5 to 6 times larger than forecocks. Right? This is a special peculiar character of Talcidae. And a high tibial spur also larger than mid tibial spur. Right? Okay, here hind femora are larger with row of short teeth beneath on each and every mid leg. Okay, and wing venation is reduced to single anterior vein. Oviposition is very short and straight. Best example is the Brachymeria, it's a pupal parasite. Next one is Megachilidae leaf cutter bee. They are solitary bee, mandibles are sharp and scissor like modification, and pollen gathering through hair scopa are present on venter of the abdomen, right? See the picture, the ventral region, there will be hair like structure, right, that will collect the pollen, and they cut the semicircular shape pieces of leaves of mostly roses, rarely it will prefer red crumb or guava, mostly it's the pest of rose. Okay, they cut pieces of leaves are used for the preparing nest, right, and provision for the brood consists of mixture of pollen mixed with the honeys. Next family, Ichneumonidae. You can say common name or Ichneumon flies. Here adults are diurnal and visit flowers in daytime, and Trochanter is two segmental, right, it's a special case. Trochanter is two segmental, and hind femur is with the trochanterless. And four wings have two recurrent wings, and petiole is curved and expanded at the apex region. Here oviposition, right, oviposition arises anterior to the tip of abdomen, that much longer than the body excited out permanently, right. Best example is Erebores trochanterless. It is an exotic larval parasite of coconut black headed caterpillar. And you can see the recurrent veins, right, or recurrent veins, or you can say median cubital veins, right, or you can say median cubital veins, that will two in the case of Ichneumonid fly and one in the case of Braconid fly, right. Next we will go see the Braconid fly. Okay, Braconid wasp, right, it's a small stout bodied insect, four wing has one recurrent veins. We have already seen the Ichneumonid fly which having two recurrent veins, right, or you can say median cubitus vein, right. Okay, that means there is a interconnecting wings between medium and cubitus, that is called the medio cubitus vein, right. That will two in the case of Ichneumonid, there will be one in the case of Braconid. Okay, they are gregarious parasite, right. What do you mean by gregarious parasite? It will come and attack by group, right. If you take solitary, only one alone will come and attack the species, that means solitary If you take gregarious means, they will come as group and cause a damage. It's a difference between solitary and gregarious. Okay, next, in many species, there will be a chance to polyembryony, right? That means in a single zygote having n number of embryos, right? That is called a polyembryony condition, right? Best example is Brachan brevicornis. It's the best larval parasitoid. Next family is Bethylidae. It's an ant-like colored wasp. Just it's like look like a ant appearance. And females of many species are wingless, right? Mostly it's a wingless. Example, Paracerola nepandidus. It's a specific larval parasitoid on coconut BHC, coconut black-headed caterpillar. Next family is Agonidae, or fig wasp. Here fig wasp, there is a structural modification present between male and female. That is, male is apterus, right, without wings. Female is only winged and have long ovipush. Their foreleg and hind legs are stout, mid legs are slender. They live inside the fig and it will pollinate. Without this wasp, fig fruit won't get pollinate. And the best example is Blastopaga senens. Next family, Giovannidae ensign wasp. Here petiole is long and abrupt. Here gaster is short, compressed and attached to propodium. See the picture, attached to propodium. Gaster is attached to propodium by slender petiole. Here gaster carried almost like a flag, right? Almost like a flag. It's just like almost like a flag, right? Gaster, and they are parasite on the cockroach eggs or Urtica. Next family, Elopidae. Here, it's a minute pupal parasite. It's narrow. It has narrow forewing with the pubescence on the wing lamella. The hairs are not arranged in rows. And ovipositor is present almost at the tip of the abdomen. Right? Best example is Tetrastegus israeli. It's a gregarious pupal parasite. Next family is Trichogrammatidae. Trichogramma species. They are minute insect. Egg parasita is a minute insect. And tarsus is three-segmented. Forewing is broad with pubescence in rows. And hind wings is reduced and fringed with the hairs along the margin. They are mainly egg parasitoid on Lepidopteran insect. So best example is Trichogramma species. Here I end my presentation. Thank you very much. Thank you all. If you have any doubts, please ask me in our WhatsApp group. Thank you very much.